you, boys and girls. How are you doing? Do you like sandwiches?
I love sandwiches. A good peanut butter and jelly, a good veggie burger, my favorite things in the world. But right now, I feel like I'm stuck in like the worst sandwich imaginable. I feel like I'm stuck inside of a sandwich that's made up of two pieces of bread. This one slice is like that before time, before we had coronavirus. And this other slice is I can see almost the end of coronavirus. And that's where we are. We're right here in the middle because we remember the past and we can sort of see the future of what might happen. See, in our reading from Corinthians, they were in this time where they were talking about how periods of life were changing and that time was moving along and there was a new age that was coming in the person of Jesus Christ. And that's kind of where we are too. We're stuck in this in-between time. And so what do we do when we're stuck in the in-between time? Well, we can look to Jesus. We can look to Jesus because Jesus is God's most perfect revelation of who God is. A person that loves us completely, that knows all of our hurts and our happies and our hang-ups and our mads and our sads and our happies and our highs and our lows. He knows them all. God knows them all. Because of Jesus, we can see a new way of being and loving in this world. We can go to Him with any hurts, any heartaches, any frustrations that we have, and God's big enough to take it into God's self. And when we do that, we lighten the load a little bit for ourselves. And when we feel a little happier, when we feel a little more cared for and nurtured, then we can go and care for others and nurture them and show them that they are loved. Because right now, we're all stuck at home. We're stuck at home inside the worst sandwich imaginable. But what do? We can treat home like school. Besides just doing the online school that so many of us are doing, we can treat home as a way to practice the sort of people that we want to be in the world around us. We can work on learning to love and learning to forgive and learning to serve those around us so that we can be ready for this time that's coming when coronavirus is no more. When it eventually goes away and we can live life the way that we want to, the way that we're used to. And when we practice at home, it's going to be so much easier to love and to serve others. It is. Home is sort of a giant, tiny school for us to practice loving people, our moms, our dads, our sisters, our brothers. If we live with grandparents, we can love on them too. Right now, we're stuck in the middle. So take this time to practice. And we know that this time will pass. We know that we're gonna make it through it together. I don't know when, but I know one of the things that I've learned in my 43 almost years of life is this too shall pass. I love you, boys and girls. You are magnificent treasures to the church, to God, and to your families. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, amen. Dear God, help us to be okay. Help us to go to you when we're having a struggle, when we're happy, when we're sad, when we have our highs and our lows. Let us go to you to tell you about those things so that we don't feel so burdened and so low. Thank you for loving us, God. Help us to love ourselves and others more every day. All right, boys and girls, we've got this. You've got this. Get to practicing. Love each other, serve each other, and remember, your church loves you, God loves you, the saints love you, your clergy at St. Augustine love you. You are magnificent. You are loved. You are treasured. Amen. Bye, y'all. My hair looks great, doesn't it? Woo!